Insight.
The first ever series to analyze the unexplored aspects and issues of Carnatic music. Dear Rasikas,
welcome to the 20th episode of our Insight series.
In the previous episodes, we had discussed about the gamakas and their various dimensions. Of course, the subject of gamakas is really very, very vast and very, very infinite. And this is because of the fact that even in the same raga, the particular note can have different dimensions to it. For example, if you take, we had discussed also about this earlier, Shankarabharanam, for example, if I take Sa Re Ga Ma Ga Ma, so there are different ways in which even a particular note can be really approached, and that's why we see that gamaka can give us so many colors within the same raga itself. We will take another example of Thodi and Dhenuka to see how both have got the same Purvangam, in the sense that the Sarigama Pa is the same in Thodi and Dhenuka, but see how the gamakas make each so different. In Dhenuka, you see Sarigama Padani Sa Sanida Pamagari Sa. But we don't sing the Sarigama Pa like this for Thodi, where you would employ a lot of gamakas like Sarigama Padani Sa Sanida Pamagari Sa Gamagari Gamapamagari Gama. So even without going into the Uttarangam, that is the Padanisa, within the Sarigama Pa itself, we'll be able to understand that this is Thodi or this is Dhenuka based on the kind of gamakam that is being used. Let's look at the composition in these respective ragas to make it more explicit. For example, in Dhenuka, Teliya leru rama bhakti magamu, Teliya leru rama, where the pamagarisa, the same thing when it comes into the Thodi, you see that it is Rajo Vedala Jutamu Rare Kasturi Raga Rajo Vedala. Once again, I'll show you the difference. Here in Thodi, Sare Ga Ma Pa Ma Ga Ga Ma Pa Ma Ga Ri Ga Ma Ga Ri. Whereas in Dhenuka, it is much more plain as we saw in the composition. The next example we can give here similarly is about Saveri and Malahari. You see that in Saveri and Malahari, the Aruna is the same and there's a slight variation in the Avarohana. But the Gamaka employed makes each one have its own distinct color. For example, if you take Malahari, all of us know the popular Geetams in this Ragam Malahari, where the Aruna Aruna looks like Sari Ma Pa Da Sa Sa Da Pa Ma Ga Ri Sa. It's not that just in the Geetam they occur in such a simplistic way without the Gamakam. We can take an example of a Dikshadhar Kirtana also to see how Malahari has been handled. Panchamatanga Mukha Ganapati Na Paripalitoham sumukena she palcha patanga mukha ganapati na paripali toham sumukena she palcha patanga mukha ganapati पचभूतात्मक प्रपञ्चोदयादिकरण पचभूतात्मक प्रपञ्चोदयादिकरण विरचिहरिरुत्रनुदेन पञ्चवक्त्र शिवसूत्रेण पञ्चमातङ्ग मुखगणपति द सेम सरिमपादसा वेन् इट् इस् पुट् इन् टु द सावेरी मोल्ड् बिकम्स् सो हेविली लेडन् वित् गमकास् लैक् सरे मा पद सानि पमयरि स सरि पमगारि सरि मामरि माप पम पद स सानि पमगरि सरि पमगारि स मुरुगा मुरुग यन्द्र उरुगदो उल्द उल्लम मुरुगा मुरुग यन्द्र उरुगदो उल्द उल्लम வருவாய் வருவாயில் பரிவோடி வராயோ முருக முருக என்ற ஒரு கால் கூரை செய்தாலும் உல்பாதோ நீடைந்தாலு அருளே தந்திடோகல்தோ பகலும் நுருக முருக என்ற உருகதோ உள்தல் உள்ளம் வருவாய் வருவாயில் பரிவோடு வராயோ முருக முருக என்ற
வேர் யூ சா தட் Though both of them did take Sarema Padasa. In Malahari, it was a straight without much of Gamakas. But in Saveri, the same thing got loaded with Gamakas. So that again is also very much an important factor in determining that this is Saveri or this is Malahari. We'll now move on to the next aspect of the Vivadi Ragas, where we see that in the Vivadi Ragas like Natai, Neetimati, Naganandini, Chalanata, like this, there are many Vivadi Ragas. Here, in the terms of the Gamaka, we see that when the Vivadi note has to be in an elongated way or sometimes in a gentle way, then what happens is that the Vivaditva gets more pronounced and you're able to have a clear vision of that particular note as a Vivadi note. What do I mean by that? For example, if you take Natai, Sari Gama, the Ri is a Vivadi here, and that note is given a very longer duration to get that feel of that Vivadi. Sari Gama Panisa,
Sa Ni Pa Ma Ga Ma Ri Sa. Or let's take another example of Niti Mati. Sa Ri Ga Ma Pa Da Ni Sa Sa Ni Ra Pa Ma Ga Ri Sa Pa Ma Ga Ri Sa Ri Ga Ma Pa Pa Ma Pa Da Pa Pa Ma Pa Da Ni Sa Ni Ra Pa Ma Ga Ri Ga Ma Pa Ma Ga Ri Ga Ma Pa Da Da Pa Ma Pa Da Da Pa Ma Pa Da 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 Pa Ma Pa Ma Pa Da Ni Sa Ni Ra Pa Ma Pa Ma Pa Da Pa Pa Da Pa Pa Da Pa Ma Ga Ri Ga Ma Pa Ma Ga Ri Sa Mohana Kar Muthukumar Shikara Karuna Karavara Marul 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 Mohana Kar Muthukumar I'll give you another example where you see that in the Purvangam as well as the Uttarangam, we have the Vivaditva. An example for this could be Chalanata, where you see in the Purvanga, Sarigama, and the Uttarangam again, Padanisa, Sanirapamagarisa. So here there is a symmetry in terms of the Vivadi, I would say, where Sariga, there in the Uttarangam, Padani. So that in this particular composition, we'll see how the Gamakas are handled in a ragam like Chalanata. We look into a composition of Sri Koteswara Iyer, which gives us a vivid description, I would say, of the ragam in terms of how each note has to be executed along with the gamakas. Ye daya gati Ye na ke 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 daya gati Madaya nidhi Madaya nidhi Umapati Madaya nidhi Umapati Sukumara vara kula nidhi Nidanallad vera daya gati Iyana ke daya gati Pedaye ninnarul kattadu ennode daya vilai yatta budala chalanata budala chalanata nirtaitan gati pugai kavi kuljar dasanik vere daya gati iyana ke daya gati So here you saw that the Vivadi note was rather very pronounced to give you that complete impact of the note. We look into some more compositions. Again, for the fact that a good composition always defines the basic contour of the raga along with the gamakas in a very, very explicit manner, I would say. The first example we could probably take is Riti Gaula here again. If you look at Subbaraya Shastri's composition, Janani Ninnu Veena Amba Janani Ninnu Veena Deke Varamma Jaga Mulo Vona Gaya. So it's not just about ni ni sa ga ga ma, it's not only about that, but how the each of these notes have to be done with the respective gamakas is what the composition gives us an idea. Ja na ni, one small example, ni ni sa. So how the ni ni sa has to be oscillated here for Riti Gaula. Ja ga bu lo ga na ga ma pa ma ga ri. So the oscillation which goes with the note is also indicated by the composition. Another example we could take is Sahana, where the heart of the ragam, as I said earlier, also lies in re 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 ga ma pa ma ga ma ri ga ri sa, where Papanasam Sivan has started that composition Chittam Irangadeneya in the reed itself. See how it beautifully he has portrayed. Chittam iranga deneya sendil velaya nimu chittam riri. So the sahana is seen replete in this composition in the starting phrase itself. Chittam iranga deneya sendil velaya nil chittam iranga deneya. To take surety, nisa nidava magaba marire shri venkata girishava lokaye vinayak turakarudam shri venkata. Same here we did Saveri earlier also, you see that Muruga, Muruga, Pamaga, Rire, Sari, Mama. Like this, we can keep going on and on to show you how a good composition can be a great example for us to understand the intricacies of each raga. Just going back to the historical element of the gamakas, we can say that there has been a reference to this concept of gamakas in many, many works. Like for example, you see in the Bharata's Natya Shastra, we see that there's a mention of the Alankaras, then Sangeeta Makaranda, Sangeeta Ratnakara. Like this, there are many works which refer to the gamakas. But then later on, I mean, there are also a difference in terms of some have defined 19 gamakas, some have said there are 15 gamakas. But finally, what we have come to a conclusion, I would say, is in terms of arriving at the Dashavida Gamakas, that is the 10 types of Gamakas. And in the Sangeeta Sampradaya Pradarshini of Subbarama Dikshad, we see that there is a beautiful explanation for each of these Gamakas. And that is really a treasure trove in terms of understanding the Gamaka itself. Why, even in Dikshad's compositions, you see that in Meenakshi Memudam, he refers to the Dashavida Gamakas as Veena Gana Dashagama Kriyeta. While referring to goddess Meenakshi in Meenakshi Memudam, he says that she is the one who plays the Dashavira Gamakas on the Veena. So there are umpteen number of references, and in the Sangeetha Sampradaya Pradarshini, we see that there is a reference to Gamaka types. Like, for example, you have the Jaru, which is a very, very important kind of a Gamakam. Jaru is the glide from one note to the next. For example, if you take Mohanam, Sari Gapadasa. So the glide from Sari, that glide, Pada, this kind of a glide is called a Jaru. Sometimes a Jaru can be very, very large, like you see in the example of Sri Satyanarayanam. Sri Satyanarayanam Upasmage. Or in a ragam like Anandabhairavi, Pada Pasa. It's a vast kind of a range from Pa to Sa. Like this, we see that Jaru is a very, very important Gamakam. Then he also makes a mention of the Janta, that is a pairing of notes. Then Odukkal. Then after that, we have what we call as the Khandip. But the most important, of course, again, is the Kampita Gamakam, that is the oscillation of the particular note. And there are different kinds of Kampita Gamakam, interestingly, as mentioned. One of them, of course, is how we oscillate a note within its own range, that is without touching the higher or lower note. For example, if you take in Kalyani, Pamagari Gama Ga. So where the Ma or the Ga oscillates within its own place and it does not touch a higher note or a lower note. Sometimes we see that the Kampitam happens with the help of the lower note. For example, if you take in Karahara Priya, Sarigama, that Ga, the oscillation happens from the Rishabha. Like this in Kampita, we see that there are different dimensions. Again, you can make an example of Begada, where you see that Da Pa Ma, where the Ma takes the help of the higher note Pa to oscillate. Da Pa Ma Ma, the Ma starts on the Pa. So like this in Kampita Gamakam, you can see a number of shades happening within each raga itself. In conclusion, we could say that the Gamaka is the most beautiful aspect of our Carnatic music, which lends every raga so many dimensions. So understanding these Gamakas, understanding the notes along with the Gamakas, the raga again, along with their notes and the gamakas, and finally while listening to a composition or a manodharma like raga, alapana, niravala or swaram, when we are able to link all these things and try to enjoy the music, it can be indeed a very, very blissful experience for the rasika. Of course, for the performer, dwelling in this world of gamakas is a very, very blissful experience, and you can just weave umpteen number of patterns because the gamakas lend so much scope for every note to be explored. With this, we come to the conclusion of this particular episode. If you have any doubts, questions, you may please email to us or WhatsApp to us. Looking forward to meeting you all in the next episode with another new and very interesting topic. Thank you.